Hi, my name is Dr. John Shim, and I would like to talk about disc bulges found on MRI. On a daily basis, I have friends and acquaintances coming to me, fearfully telling me that their doctor ordered an MRI and it showed a slipped disc to their spine. Because I know that finding seems like a serious problem, I'm very careful in my response to that statement. What the general population may not know is that disc findings on MRIs are expected for anybody over the age of 40. In fact, many episodes of neck and back pain are not because of a disc problem, but rather because of a pull or a stretching of the muscles, ligaments, and tendons holding your spine bones together. It's not a slipped disc that was identified on the MRI. As a spinal specialist, I know that findings on MRIs may not have anything to do with your pains. At the same time, those findings can be cause of specific complaints and findings. A lot depends on the pains and the actual physical findings identified by your doctor. With proper counseling, most people will understand that MRI findings such as a disc bulge or small herniation will not likely be a significant problem, and in fact, those are expected changes associated with age, genetics, and an active lifestyle. MRI is a pretty good screening tool to make sure you do not have anything bad like a tumor or infection. At the same time, it's a very costly test, and based on your complaints and medical history, most physicians will already have a pretty good idea if you have something significant. So, if you have disc findings on your MRI, but if you're getting better and your complaints are not that severe, it's highly unlikely that those disc findings are going to give you significant long-term concern. To me, often it's the anxiety of not knowing what's on the MRI that causes the increasing pain. For most people, as long as there's not anything significant, as long as there's not a significant weakness, as long as there's not a severe pain or numbness, an immediate MRI is not necessary. That's why it's now recommended to wait at least 6 to 8 weeks before getting an MRI for what we'll describe as a straightforward neck and back pain episode. Right now, scientists are testing ways to identify whether MRI findings are actually a cause of pain at that time. Unfortunately, these testings still require sampling tissue, and therefore needles and injections around the area of concern are necessary. But the future is to explore whether pain is caused by findings on studies such as MRIs. The medical community is working hard to answer that question. This is Dr. John Shim talking about MRI findings. I hope this video gave you some helpful information.